Of course, we do have that clarification on the other expenses. It includes the forex loss, etc. But let's start by talking about the top line itself. You know, the realizations this time have been hit because of the exposure that you have to the North Indian market. The sales growth has been good, almost about 19-odd% or so. But tell us what the expectation is going ahead. The volumes at about 7 million tons, do you think that's something that you could sustain over the next few quarters as well? How is demand shaping up?
Demand is shaping up very well. This is an election year, so the demand growth will be more than normal. And as you have seen, 19% growth is there. So we have entered some new markets which were not our traditional market. Yeah. Mm. And in the process, a little bit realization also have come down. Freight also have increased. But this will recover as it was the new market. Things were not normalized. Our dealership network was new. So gradually the realizations will increase and the volumes also will be robust. We expect better times ahead as good demand year. This is a good demand year.
Okay. Good morning, Mr. Bangur. Can you explain this FX loss? Is it a one-off? Will it recur? Why did it happen?
This is a FX loss, but we had purchased a unit in Russell Khema for roughly $300 million. Now out of those $300 million, $250 million were sent from here. We had taken the loan for our other expansion here, but then as we have exposure in Middle East in dollar terms, okay, we wanted to keep same amount of dollar exposure unhedged. Okay. So that dollar to dollar itself will be hedged.
Okay.
So in a way, it is a one-off, and covering it would have been risking ourselves.
All right.
It is a peculiar case where de-risking is better.
Okay.
So what could the adjusted margins be for the company over the next few quarters?
Margins is a matter of sales rate, but we expect sales rates to be good. Costing will be in control. Margins, it will be difficult to predict.
No, you've been doing 21, 22. See, if we took off this FX issue, then this quarter as well, you have done over 21%. So is that the broad ballpark?
Yes, it should be a little better only, if not the same.
Okay, okay. Has the petcoke usage stabilized now? No more issues?
Now, petcoke is an overhyped subject. It was very relevant 10 years back.
Mm.
Now, petcoke prices and coal prices are differing by 2 to 3% only.
Okay.
Company has everywhere full flexibility to use either petcoke or coal.
Oh, I see.
And many of times, coal is cheaper.
Mm.
So, right now, we are using roughly 40% coal and 60% petcoke as it is.
Okay.
Okay. What were the realizations in this quarter? What was the exact realizations and what can we expect over the next few quarters?
Realization was about 3,900 rupees,
okay,
instead of 4,100 rupees last time, roughly 5% lower.
Okay.
Going forward, we can expect a better realization than this. As I was saying, our margins will increase, and such low realizations and low margins are not going to remain.
Okay.
Sometimes it has to be passed on to consumer.
Okay. Okay. So you should expect a rise in prices is what you're saying?
Yes, I say.
Okay. Mr. Bangur, you know, the sales volume is actually a lot of companies have surprised us with higher than expected sales volume. Can you give us an idea of how the demand is looking like right now? We are in monsoon, but even comparing monsoon to monsoon, is it better? Are you expecting it to be better?
Definitely it is better. Now, Government of India is doing many of the infrastructure projects, 500 to 1,000 crore rupees,
okay,
where a lot of cement is needed, and that demand is coming and not much noise is being made. So everywhere, this is an election year, as I was saying.
Yes.
Demand will be good, infrastructure growth is good, government expenditure is good. And monsoon to monsoon also, demand rise will be substantial. Normally, the cement demand rises by 7 to 8%. This year, it will be in double digit.
What is the geographic breakup of this demand growth? Where is it better? Where is it not so good?
Demand growth is there all throughout India. For us, because of low base in East, our East demand, sales increase is about 35%, while North is only 12%. But 12%, I have to say only, even though it is a double-digit growth.
Yeah, I agree.
Okay. So just one more question, clarification. Two costs for you. The freight costs, which rose about 14% this time because of higher diesel prices, and employee costs, which rose because of the manpower that you hired for the Karnataka plant. Should we expect these costs to continue?
Yes, the cost will continue, but as a percentage of revenue, it will come down. As Karnataka plant is expected to start somewhere by September end, so for 3 to 6 months, these costs will be there. Gradually, the volumes in these Karnataka plants and other units will pick up, and these will come down as a percentage of sales, or they will remain the same.
Okay. Can you give us an idea of how much better demand will be? I mean, I know it's asking a tough number, but still your best guess in terms of volume growth for the year.
I was expecting more than 10% for the industry as a whole.
Okay.
And Shree Cement should be doing a little better than that.
All right. Okay. And what about EBITDA per ton? Even this is sustainable? I mean, what is that, 850?
This EBITDA per ton this quarter should be bettered in all subsequent quarters this year.
Okay. That's a strong statement.
Just one more question. You know, these axle load norms have been changed. Now overloading, you know, can be done, etc. Any analysis of how this could help you or it could impact the cement industry at all?
Now, overloading cannot be done. The new norms for loading has been fixed. So it will be always within the norms, the loading will be done.
Okay.
And secondly, these will make the competitive, the cement will be available, competitive, nation will be saving a lot of diesel. It is good in all respects.